My name is Amy Allen, and last week I started my first vending machine company. And one of the hardest things that I found about opening and starting a vending machine company is finding what kind of machine I wanted to buy. Think of it as like buying a car. There's so many different kinds of models out there, the Kias, the Hondas, the Toyotas, the Lamborghinis. It's kind of the same thing with a vending machine. Now you have to figure out which machine you want to buy. You can go anywhere between a Royal, a Sega, a Futura, a Crane, a Nation, a USI. So many different options. And with all of those different options, there's better ones and there's worse ones. So being the professional I am, I scoured throughout the internet. I read every post that I possibly could. I commented on other people's videos, asking questions. I went onto groups, I went onto Craigslist. Anybody who was willing to answer me my questions, I asked. So right off the bat, if all you came here to see in this video, here's the list. Yeah, so go ahead. This is the good and the bad. The way you can differentiate a machine between good and bad is how easy you can get the parts for it, or how often do they break down. This is the Futura. The Futura is one of the combo ones that is very good and has USI products. This is the Genesis. The Genesis isn't American made and is very hard to get any of the parts if anything does break down, so it's not a fan favorite. The DN600E. The DN600E is a fan favorite. If you ever need a soda machine, go with one of those. The AMS. The AMS is an American made vending machine. It's one of the ones that I have too, so that's the one that I picked up. The Crane 157. Anytime I mention the Crane 157 in a post or in some sort of blog or something, it was always a fan favorite. It's a very good machine, it's very reliable, and it's made in the US. All of the Segas are really bad for parts. If anything were to break down, it's gonna take weeks for you to even obtain it, and then that's weeks without money. This is the USI 3155. It's very reliable, but very hard to move. So you have to imagine what your poor movers are gonna go through when they're trying to squeeze it in through the little doors for you. The Row 4900. It's horrible. If anybody's ever trying to sell this one, no offense, but you should probably just get rid of it, put it out of its misery. It's time. And now the most famous one that I see, and I'm pretty sure it's the most famous one that you've seen whenever you go on to OfferUp or Craigslist, is going to be the Perco. The Perco OD16S. Now I almost bought this one myself. When I almost bought this one is because it looked like it needed everything that I needed. The snacks, the sodas, the full combo, everything. And there's a lot of people who were selling it in my area. I decided not to, because when I asked questions, which you should always ask questions, by the way, when I went to go ask questions about this machine and whether or not it was a good deal, everybody said no, that it's always breaking down, that the parts are really bad. The good machines are USI, Crane, Ridden, AM, LCM4, AP, Royal, Dixie, AMS, National, Narco, and DN600E. The bad machines are Polyven, Sega, Gaines, Vendrotronics, Jofomar, and of course anything made in China. Remember that the fastest tricks I can give you is to buy something that's AP, so something that's automatic, and buy something that is made in the US. Another piece of advice I can give you is to only buy a machine that has one door and one lock on it. When you're going out and searching, there's going to be some combo machines that offer two doors where you have to open the first hatch in order to get to the snacks, and then you have to open the second hatch in order to get to the drinks. There are combos out there to where you just open one door and you have access to everything. Those are your best ones. The Perco, for example, that one had three doors, and the three doors is a sign that it's not a good machine. Personally, you don't have to do this, but personally, I am only going to be buying APs and only going to be buying American-made vending machines. I only have the two combos right now, but hopefully my next machines are going to be the single machines, you know, one machine for soda and one machine for snacks. I'd like to see how much volume it could have and how many times a week I'd have to go and stuff. Some of you wanted to know where I bought my machine from, and I actually got my machine locally. After I went and asked a million questions on all the different people, a lot of people referred me to Mark Batista. Mark Batista is a person that has like a little mini warehouse in Corona, and it's not too far away from me, so I decided to go on over to the warehouse and meet him and see his selection of vending machines. And the only way I was able to meet him is networking. You know, if I didn't put myself out there and I didn't ask these questions and, in my opinion, look a little silly or look like I didn't know what I was talking about because I didn't know what I was talking about, I wouldn't have been able to meet him. And if I didn't meet him, then I wouldn't have my machines right now because I was really uncomfortable buying a used machine off of OfferUp solely based on the fact that it could break down. And if it breaks down, I don't know how to fix it, which means I'm back kind of at like square one, to where I'd have to go and find somebody to help me fix my machine, either on Yelp or on Facebook or on OfferUp. And then I've never met this person, and yet they're gonna come over here so that I can fix my business. It's weird. So Mark Batista offered me warranty, and with that warranty, it was basically a done deal. I ended up buying two combo machines. And for the other question that I've been getting asked is how much were my machines each costed $1,500. So a grand total of $3,000 for two machines. And the machines are mine completely. I'm not renting them, I'm not leasing them. I went ahead and bought them from Mark Batista. You don't necessarily have to spend $1,500 per machine like I did, but I do think you should be spending at least $1,000. Whether it has warranty or it doesn't have warranty. When I was looking into getting the machines for $600 and $800, I was just getting so worried. It looked like it wouldn't even survive the move. And even if it looks nice on the outside, I was so worried that because I didn't know what was on the inside or what to even look for on the inside, that I just decided to go for the comfort of it. But yeah, I don't necessarily recommend anything that costs under $600, especially if you're gonna be a beginner. If you know how to work the machines and you know how to fix them up and you've been doing this for years, then yo, yes, this isn't the video for you. Go do your thing. But if you're a brand new person like I am, then you gotta spend at least $1,000 per machine. And try to get some warranty. Try to find your own Mark Batista in your city, county, states. When I first started researching, how am I gonna get a machine? How am I gonna get locations? How am I gonna get everything? The very first thing I was like, oh, I'll just, you know, buy a $600 machine and my startup costs aren't gonna be very expensive. But my startup costs grew and grew and grew faster and faster. And I almost backed out. I almost completely backed out. I thought this is too much money. I don't even know if this is gonna work, but so far I'm having fun with it. And so far it's been a little easier than I imagined. It just required a little bit more money. Not only did the machines cost me $3,000 and have the 90-day warranty that helped me and my peace of mind, the product that went inside the machine that's gonna be able to help me load it up at least twice came out to $400 in total. So it was about $200 worth of product per machine that should, in theory, last me a month. Remember, this is the first time I have a machine, so this part is just a theory. I don't know how long it'll take me to finish that product. I do know it doesn't expire for at least 2 months. So either it'll be gone in 2 weeks and that's even better for me, or it's gonna take a month, then that's still fine. As long as it gets sold, it's perfectly fine. But the product itself, which I bought at Sam's, was $400 in total, and that's to fill two of my machines for 1 month. Hopefully. Maybe. I don't know. But yeah, if you have any other questions, just let me know. I'm trying to be as informative as humanly possible, and next week is going to be the first day I go collect. I have absolutely no idea what to expect. You know, it's nice seeing Jaime pull out hundreds of dollars of bills out of his vending machines, but I don't necessarily know if that is the right expectations for me. So hopefully it's not a dollar, but hopefully it's somewhere in the hundreds. But I will definitely show you guys next week. you have any questions, just leave them down below. I'll be happy to answer any of them, maybe even do like a Q&A.